Francis. Good morning. Let's sing Song of the Garden. The Lord into his garden comes, the spices yield a rich perfume. The lilies grow and thrive, the lilies grow and thrive. Refreshing showers of grace divine from the Father flows to every vine and makes the dead revive and makes the dead revive. Oh, that this dry and barren ground in springs of water may abound. A fruitful soil become, a fruitful soil become. The desert blossoms as a rose when the Savior conquers all his foes and makes his people one, and makes his people one. Come, brethren, you that love the Lord and taste the sweetness of his words. In Father's ways go on, in Father's ways go on. Our troubles and our trials here will only make us richer there. When we arrive at home, when we arrive at home. Now it's already 5 a.m. Let's all rise. Let's begin our Hoon Dok Hae.
L31, sending bow to our beloved Hoon Dok Hae. And Wa Temple in the Kurdiyake, Kinde, Baro, our most beloved Heavenly Parents, today, Wednesday, January the 21st, 2015, we pray for the victory, the protection, the defense, and the fulfillment of the dreams and aspirations of our true parents. We pray for a true father in the heavenly realm, a true mother here on earth, and the rest of the true family, the true children, true grandchildren, and the brothers and sisters who are taking care of us. We pray for their protection always, as we pray for our leaders who are in constant communication with our true mother, that they will always unite with her. And we pray for our international headquarters in Kingston, Korea. My elder sister, Sunjin, and her husband, Aishin, we pray for their success and they can, we pray that they can reach their goal today. And we pray as well for the family come, we pray for here in America, Reverend Hoon Dok Hae about the wife and the children, and we start their call and force to speak. We pray for the newly chosen vice president, like our Reverend Hoon Dok Hae, who came here last Sunday, and we pray for their success always, their intellectual service, to utilize that info, and we pray for all the regions and districts all over the world. We pray for our district leader, for the murder pattern, and our state department, and all the children, black children, their children, here in the Mid-Atlantic area. We pray also for the parents and state leaders all over the world. And we pray for the soldiers and temporary pastor James Stewart, who is why by the community and the children and the congregation there. We pray for the status, we pray for Reverend Akira Hotan, the North Tender, and the Father Indian Violet, and his wife by the time Richmond, Virginia. And in the Beltway, we pray for Mr. Moon. And in Maryland, for the ministers and co-pastors, Reverend Greg Jones, and Reverend Moody, and here in Washington D.C., we pray for Archbishop Joseph Fowler, who heads the American Clergy and Leadership Conference, the ACLC, and our pastor, Reverend Zagery Oliver, my hometown of Georgia, our church council, and all the best families coming more than 30 years in the Washington D.C. area. We pray that we have more members. And we have the second generation for a full and new pressure. On this weekend, we will have good results in inviting couples to attend the interstate blessing. Gradually, we can invite all these people in our centers of influence. And we pray for such success as we bring in more people who can help us bring in thousands of people here and connecting them. And we pray all this in all our names, and in my name, for that sign, speak to our blessing of the family.
Good morning. We're now on page 888. And we have here the subtopic under humility and self-denial about repentance. Subtopic 3. Genuine repentance requires changing behavior. Again, we're on page 888 in the World Scriptures and Teachings of our Father, Reverend Son Myung Moon. And whosoever repents and does good, he verily repents towards God with true repentance. And this is from the Quran, Surah 25, verse 71 from Islam. If a man finds that he has made a mistake, then he must be afraid of admitting the fact and amending his ways. And this is from Analect 1.8.4, Confucianism. Whosoever looks upon his wrongdoing as wrongdoing, make amends by confessing it as such and abstains from it in the future, will progress according to the law. And this from Dighanikaya 1.85 Buddhism. How is one proved a repentant sinner? Rabbi Judah said, if the object which caused his original transgression comes before him on two occasions and he keeps away from it. Rabbi Jose ben Judah said, if a man commits a transgression the first, second, and third time, he is forgiven. The fourth time, he is not forgiven. And this is from the Talmud, Yoma 86, B, Judaism. He who has committed a sin and has repented is freed from that sin, but he is purified only by resolving to cease. I will do so no more. He who, having either unintentionally or intentionally committed a reprehensible deed, desires to be freed from it, must not commit it a second time. If his mind be uneasy with respect to any deed, let him repeat the penances prescribed for it until they fully satisfy his conscience. And this is from the laws of Manu 11, that verses 231 to 234. Hinduism. Expiation and repentance. To a man who continues to commit sinful acts, knowing them to be harmful, are of no avail. Futile is it to bait an elephant if he is straightway to roll again in mud. And this is from Srimad Bhagavatam 6.1 Hinduism. Say, O my slaves who have been prodigal to their own church, despair not of the mercy of God, who forgave all sins. Lord, he is the forgiving, the merciful. Turn to him, repentant, and surrender unto him. Before there can come upon you the doom when you cannot be helped, and follow the better of that which has been revealed unto you from your Lord, before the doom comes on you suddenly when you know not, lest any soul should say, alas, my grief that I was unmindful of God, and I was indeed among the scoffers. Or should say, if God had but guided me, I should have been among the dutiful. Or should say, when it sees the doom, oh, that I had but a second chance, that I might be among the righteous. And this is from the Quran, Surah 39, verses 53 to 58. Do not procrastinate the day of your repentance until the end, for after this day of life, which is given us to prepare for eternity, behold, if we do not improve our time while in this life, then comes the night of darkness, wherein there can be no labor performed. You cannot say, when you are brought to that awful crisis, that I will repent, that I will return to my God. Nay, you cannot say this, for that same spirit which possesses your bodies at the time that you go out of this life, that same spirit will have power to possess your body in that eternal world. For behold, if you have procrastinated the day of your repentance, even until death, behold, you have become subjected to the spirit of the devil, and he has sealed you his. And this is from the Book of Mormon, Alma, chapter 34, verses 33 to 35. And this is from the Latter-day Saints. And now, we're on page 889, the teachings of our Father, Reverend Son Myung Moon. We are people who recognize that we are in a disordered and diseased state, and we have come to this place to be repaired. We have individual problems, family problems, national level problems, and global problems, all of which need fixing. How then can you prove that you are completely healed? You are in good shape when you feel disgust for your old self and your former way of life. Do you still have fond memories of those days? Do you sometimes dream of the good times you used to have? If so, it means you have not yet fully recovered from your illness. Again, you meet a handsome man who whispers in your ear, "You are beautiful. Why don't you forget about that difficult husband of yours and come live with me?" If such a temptation pulls you in the slightest, it means you have not yet fully recovered from your illness. You are cured when you have become immune to such temptations, when they do not affect you at all. And this is from a speech on May 1, 1978. Most people's lives vacillate back and forth between good and evil, between a public life and a self-centered life. They often end up falling into a self-centered life, but if they continue that way, they are destined to perish. Therefore, from time to time, they repent of their self-centered past and strive once again to live a public life, biting their teeth. Nevertheless, they do not endure it for long and again fall back into self-centeredness. In such a way, people vacillate back and forth. Eventually, they are inclined to live a private life, distant from the standard of public goodness. Most people's lives of faith have been like that. This is why people who lead private lives need to continually repent. And this is from a speech on June the 4th, 1970. Although God joyfully receives you this day, you should nevertheless have a tearful heart of thorough repentance. Question yourself, why did I not know Heavenly Father sooner? And why did I not understand the standpoint of God, who is so worried over humankind? When you think of your former ignorance, you should wail with indignation. God will sympathize with you if you have a heart of repentance over the past. If you lack a heart of repentance, you have no business participating in God's work. And this is from a speech in April 14, 1964. Until the last moment of your life, you should be repenting. You must not leave the earth without doing it. And this is from a speech on September 1, 1978. And now we have a new topic, Judge Not. And this is from 889, page 889. Scripture cautions us not to judge another person's thoughts, even when they are evident, because neither are we perfect and free from error. Scriptures of all faiths echo Jesus' teaching not to regard the speck in your neighbor's eye before removing the log from your own eye. Father Moon teaches the rule of three before criticizing another person. One, criticize yourself three times. Furthermore, before we correct another person, we should first invest in loving and helping them. Now we turn to page 890. Judge not, that you be not judged. For with the judgment that you pronounce, you will be judged, and the measure you give will be the measure you get. Why do you see the speck that is in your brother's eye, but do not notice the log that is in your own eye? Or how can you say to your brother, let me take the speck out of your eye, when there is the log in your own eye? You hypocrite, first take the log out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to take the speck out of your brother's eye. And this is from a speech from the book of Matthew, chapter 7, verses 1 to 5. Easily seen are others' faults, hard indeed to see are one's own. Like chaff, one winnows others' faults, but one's own one hides, as a crafty fowler conceals himself by camouflage. He who sees others' faults is ever irritable, his corruption grows. He is far from the destruction of the corruption. And this is from the Mapada 252-253. And this is from Buddhism. The vile are ever prone to detect the faults of others, though they may be as small as mustard seeds, and persistently shut their eyes against their own, though they be as large as Vilva fruit, Garuda Purana 112. And this is from Hinduism. Do not judge your comrade until you have stood in his place. And this is from Mishnah Avot 2.5 Judaism. A man holding a basket of eggs does not dance on stone. This is from Buji, Proverb African Traditional Religion. Confucius said, the gentleman calls attention to the good points in others. He does not call attention to their defects. The small man does just the reverse of this. And this from the Analects 12.16, Confusion Eden. Why do you pass judgment on your brother, or you, why do you despise your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God, as it is written, "As I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall confess to God." So each of us shall give account of himself to God. And this is from the book of Romans, chapter 14, verses 10 to 12. The scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery, and placing her in the midst, they said to him, "Teacher, this woman has been caught in the act of adultery. Now in the law of Moses commanded us to stone such. What do you say about her?" This they said to test him, that they might have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. And as they continued to ask him, he stood up and said to them, "Let him who is without sin among you be the first to throw a stone at her." And once more he bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. But when they heard it, they went away one by one, beginning with the eldest, and Jesus was left alone with the woman standing before him. Jesus looked up and said to her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She said, "No one, Lord." And Jesus said, "Neither do I condemn you. Go and do not sin again." And this is from the book of John, chapter 8, verses 3 to 11. He who treads the path in earnest sees not the mistakes of the world. If we find fault in others, we ourselves are also in the wrong. When other people are in the wrong, we should ignore it, for it is wrong for us to find fault. By getting rid of this habit of fault finding, we cut off a source of defilement. When neither hatred nor love disturb our mind, serenely we sleep. This is from Sutra of Hua Hui Ning to Buddhism. Censuring our others and praising himself, concealing good qualities present in others, and proclaiming the noble qualities absent in himself, he causes them to have low status, disparaging himself and praising others, proclaiming qualities which are present in others and not proclaiming those that are absent in himself. With humility and modesty, he lifts them to high status. No obstacle should be created in the open and close bracket spiritual development of others. And this is from Tattvartha Sutra, chapter 6, verses 25 to 27 from Jainism. And now it's 5:28. We have here the teachings of our Father, Reverend Son Myung Moon, and you have your Reverend Ezra to read further the teachings of our Father on judge not.
We read page 891, the teachings of our true father, the Reverend Dr. Son Myung Moon. We read, before judging someone, study him for at least 3 years. This is from Way of God's Will 2.2. And we read, do not criticize others. The problem is within you. A weak point of young people is that their minds are stretched out in all directions, like tree branches. Do you know what I mean? They are perceptive and quick. After one glance, they are quick to make comments. However, they tend to overlook themselves. Therefore, before you criticize someone, you should first find 3 points to criticize in yourself. Be only one third as critical of that person as you are of yourself. And this is from a speech given September 30th, 1969. And we read, do not judge anyone in your heart. You yourself are a sinner, a priest who failed to complete your responsibility. So how can you judge others? And this is a speech given to us December 4th, 1976. And we read, when you receive God's grace, you should use it to fight Satan on behalf of God with the heart of heaven's indignation. You should not judge other people based on your opinions. To enjoy the grace you receive, in bracket, while passing judgment on others who receive less, close bracket, is not the right attitude of faith. If you do so, you will not be able to walk the path acceptable to God. Wow. And this is a speech given to us May 19th, 1957. And we read, if you are deficient in your character, listen to other people's testimonies to make up for it. Listen to them, absorb their experiences as your own, and strengthen your character thereby. You should learn from many people's experiences. Do not criticize their testimonies after hearing them. To criticize means to set yourself up as determining whether it is on the side of Satan or God. But in so doing, it is you who are split to be either on Satan's side or God's side. Wow. Therefore, criticism is like cancer to your growth. And this is a speech of February 2nd, 1975. And we read, examine yourself before you speak ill of another. You should look at whether you have that problem before you point the finger at another. You should first point it at yourself. Only when you can give yourself a perfect call on every point. Are you in a position to judge others as you wish? Jesus taught this when he encountered the men who were about to stone to death a woman who had committed adultery. He said to them, "Let he who is without sin cast the first stone," and they all ran away. Doesn't this also apply to you? You women should not praise your own offspring while criticizing other people's children. Rather, you should regard yourself as representing all womankind and love every mother's child as your own. It is the same with you men. And this is a speech given to us June 6, 1982. Very powerful. Yeah. Oh, it's already 5:35. On the next page, 892, we have a new topic, self-denial, and we will reach here and continue on that tomorrow. Is there anyone who wants to comment on what we read today? We read from page 888, the third subtopic on repentance. Genuine repentance requires changing behavior, and we came to the page 889, judge not, and up to page 891, we read the teachings of our true father on the topic, judge not. We see this is a very sensitive topic to many of us, and challenge, and very challenging, because we live with our brothers and sisters, and we know we all have our four fallen natures, and we have four types of sin, and that's already a very huge scope of, you know, coming from our fallen ancestors, and we are in the midst of working it out for ourselves based on the guidance and the teachings of let's say the Old Testament age, New Testament age, and now we are with true parents, completed Testament age, and right now actually we are in Chinilgu. So true father said no shadows, everything should be at noon. Yeah. So these shadows come because of even trying to judge others. And you cannot see yourself first. And it's a very, people have very diverse views of the truth. And it is a challenge for us to keep reading the Word of God, so which brings us closer and closer to really knowing the truth, and knowing when we empty ourselves of all concepts of people. We also, when we look at others, we see their good points, we start to see their good point and promote their good point. then those people will also promote our good points. And we can develop on and grow on developing the original nature of our friends, of our brothers and sisters, of our wives, spouses, and that way we encourage each other's original mind. And as we continue equipping ourselves with the Word of God and getting closer and closer to God, and we know that when we in the world, we are coming from a world which judges people, and they even inflict punishment on people, and even people grow up with prejudice. Yeah, we grew up all thinking of these people are less than us and we are higher or we are better. Even Christians thought they are better and started to think other religions are not as good. And all these kind of things is what today's reading is helping us to really analyze ourselves and come empty ourselves of concepts and know that the archangel did not have a pure mind when he looked at Adam and Eve. He already had jealousy that God had given them so much. They were given more love, and he was already feeling resentment that it's like he was the one receiving all the love before, but now that love is going somewhere else, and he started to want to change and swap places and making his own ways. And he could no longer see Adam and Eve from God's viewpoint. And we know that's our first fallen nature, not to see things from God's viewpoint. So to see things from God's viewpoint, we first must abandon, withdraw, and completely give up, and empty ourselves, and come to the zero point. Then at the zero point, we can ask God to fill us with his view of others and the value of others and the goodness of others, and we can begin to praise the good points in them and encourage what is good in them, and they will also start to feel that they look at us positively. And I'm still remembering those words of Martin Luther King. Those were really, really powerful words where we read, yesterday or the day before, turn the other cheek. Yeah, on page 882, it says, to our most bitter opponents, we say, we shall match our capacity to inflict suffering by your capacity to endure suffering. We shall meet your physical force with soul force. Do to us what you will, and we shall continue to love you. Throw us in jail, and we shall still love you. stand your hooded perpetrators of violence into our community at the midnight hour and beat us and leave us half dead, and we shall still love you. We shall so appeal to your heart and conscience that we shall win you in the process, and our victory will be a double victory. That is really, really so profound, said only in the 1960s, because all of us must have been born. So this is words of our own time. And if we can live with this mindset, we would solve so many things. We would love our enemy and win our enemy, and that is what is called double victory. We will have won ourselves to God, and then we will win our enemy to God also. And they will surrender and come to God by themselves because of our love and because of not judging them, but using the soul force of love, true love, as we have seen with our two father. He has been to jail 6 times. He has been persecuted in our own lifetime. We bear witness to all this, but father never said a word to them or anyone. He continued to pursue the way to save mankind and to teach mankind and all of us the profound way of God's will. So thank you very much. We'll reach here and ask God to help us not to judge. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Ernesta. Is there anybody else who wants to share about our reading today? So the other religions are very profound too, you know. In Buddhism, they mention about easily seeing our others' faults, hard indeed to see our own, one's own, like shaft. One winnows others' faults, but one's own one hides, as a crafty fowler conceals himself by camouflage. So he who sees others' faults is ever irritable, his corruption grows. Is far from the destruction of the corruption from Buddhism. And in from Confucianism is very clear. Confucius said, the gentleman calls attention to the good points in others, and he does not call attention to their defects. The small man does just the reverse of this.
Yeah.
He calls attention to their defects. And even in Jainism, censuring others and praising himself, concealing good qualities present in others, and proclaiming noble qualities absent in himself. So we have false, he causes them to have low status, disparaging himself and praising others, proclaiming qualities that are present in others and not proclaiming those that are absent in himself. With humility and modesty, he lifts them up, them to high status. No obstacle should be created in the development of others, or, open and close brackets, spiritual development of others in Sattva Sutra Jainism. They're talking about the same thing. In one of the speeches of Father, too, before we admonish or criticize a person, He says that we need to criticize ourselves three times before, you know, we, so that we will only be one-third as critical of that person as you are of yourself. But in one of his speeches, we need to say five good things of this person before we even admonish or even give him some, you know, pointers on what he is doing. And we praise the good things he does so that he will remember only the good things, you know, and forget at least the one that he is doing, or maybe he make a correction on himself, which is when we were reading about repentance. Genuine repentance requires changing behavior. So whosoever looks upon his wrongdoing as wrongdoing, make amends by confessing it as such and abstain from it in the future, will progress according to the law. So in many other religions, they said you might do it the second, third time, but the fourth time is already something else. This is from Judaism. If a man commits a transgression the first, second, and third time, he is forgiven. The fourth time, he is not forgiven. And for today also, we read about Father here, that we examine ourselves before we speak ill of another. We should look at whether we have that problem. Because right now, we read today that it might be you or we ourselves, you know, that we are, you know, if you are let's say you do not criticize others, the problem is within you. He said a weak point of young people is that their minds are stretched out in all directions, like tree branches. Yes, do you know what I mean? They are perceptive and quick. After one glance, they are quick to make comments. However, they tend to overlook themselves. Therefore, before you criticize someone, you should first find three points to criticize in yourself. So be only one-third as critical of that person as you are of yourself. So, wow. Yes, anybody else who wants to share? And this is very, very profound too. That Father says that you women should not praise your own offspring while criticizing other children, our people, children. So rather, you should regard yourself as representing all womankind and love every mother's child as your own. So it is the same with you men. So I experienced this with, a grandmother of, related to my grandmother. He always, praise his children always, and the other children are always bad, you know. So my son is like this and that, and even he was talking ill about my father, and we were in front of her, and then my relatives are also in front of her. So we were just looking at each other, you know, why he was praising his own son and criticizing others. So it would be a lesson that we should not do that, because, you know, the other people would not like you if you are criticizing others, but praising your own son or your own child. But it should be as lifting them up to high status by proclaim the good points. Those and we should not even proclaim that he is absent in ourselves, but use his presence, the proclaiming qualities which are present in others. So from Jainism, Judaism, Buddhism, Confucianism, and even Father's way, you know, is teaching us not to judge. And in fact, he said, before judging someone, study him for at least 3 years. So it's a very, very long time to judge someone. That he is really like that. You know, you need to study. Wow. And it's from the way of God. Yes, anybody who wants to share about our reading today, judge not, and genuine repentance requires changing behavior. If there's none, let's all rise and have a unison prayer.
Our most beloved Heavenly Parents, we're so thankful for this meeting today, for judging others, and if we are critical upon ourselves, we even forget your teaching. We pray somebody 5 times before just telling them about their fault. We pray that we can always be critical about ourselves before we say something to others. We pray that we can always be your instrument always to lift up others and their children and their people and their nation before criticizing them. We pray that this will be done all over the world. This will be a good world to live where people will be just facing others and putting down others. And we pray that we can share this with our ambassadors for peace, to our children, to other people, our friends and relatives that are even critical to us and even judging us by the good things that we have done for them. We pray that you'll come to realize that this movement is really in building a world of peace, and we are doing business for others. And we pray that we'll come to realize that all the teachings of our Father are the right way, the good one that is in function with the world purpose, as we have read today. And we pray for the Father's success as we do this to many other people around us. And we pray all of you, in all our names, and in my name, as a man of Christ, we give you our blessed and our family, our Jews, Uri
children and all our brothers and sisters who
good morning.
Good morning, have a nice and wonderful Wednesday. There'll be light snow until afternoon, maybe 1 inch. Be care, just be safe. Yeah, good morning, sister. Okay, God bless you too.